Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let's look at the new features of Safari in iPadOS. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So iPadOS, also known as iOS 13 for iPad, changes the Safari browser to be a desktop browser rather than a mobile browser. So that means web pages on your iPad should now look and work just like they do on a desktop computer, not a phone. And with that come several great new features. So let's start by looking at the new website view menu. This is the little button at the left side of the address field. It looks like two letter A's. Tap that and you get a bunch of controls. First, you get the ability to zoom in on just the text, which is something you can do in a desktop browser. So if I hit the larger A, it will change the size of the text, but not zoom in on the entire web page. And you can zoom out as well. In addition, you've got Reader View, which is what we had there in place of that button before. You could also hide the toolbar. You get it back by simply tapping near the top of the screen. You can request the mobile website if you'd rather see the mobile version of this website. And you also have website settings, which is similar to what you have in Safari on the desktop. You go into that and you have settings for this individual site. So you can set it to request the desktop website or the mobile website. You can request it to use the reader view automatically if available on a page on that site. You can also change access to things. So if you have allowed access for your camera for a website or a microphone or a location, here's where you could turn it off or switch it. You can tap it there and you can have it deny, allow, or just go back to asking you every time. Now also in the toolbar on the top, you may notice a new icon there. It's a download menu. You tap that and it shows you your downloads, just like it would on a desktop. So you would see a progress bar there if there's a download in progress. Otherwise, you will see your previous downloads you can clear, and you can hit that little magnifying glass there and it will jump to the Files app to your Downloads folder. That's right, in the Files app now, you've got a Downloads folder just like on the Mac. So what about Uploads? You do have a new feature in Uploads as well. If you go to upload a file, you can, just as before, choose from a file, you can choose from your photo library if it's looking for an image. If you choose an image, you can then choose the size for the image. Notice there at the bottom it says choose image size. I can tap that and go large, medium, small, or actual size just like I can on Safari for Mac. Now notice here I've got a bunch of different tabs open. What if I have a ton of tabs open and I want to search for one? Or maybe I forget I have a website open in a tab and I decide to go to that web page separately. When you do a search, you won't only get the regular search results, but you'll get a switch to tab feature there. So you can see I could tap that and it just jumps to that tab. That's a new feature on macOS Catalina as well. Now when you go to share a website, you've got some new options. If you look at the top of the share sheet there, you have an options button. You tap that and now you can share as PDF or web archive. You can set it to one of those two specifically. Using automatic for the web is just going to give you a link to share. Also with tabs, if you tap and hold a tab, you're going to get some options there. You can arrange tabs by title or arrange them by website. And with tabs, you can also save all of your tabs as bookmarks. So for instance, if I like these four tabs open and I want to have a set of bookmarks for them, I could tap and hold the bookmarks button at the top left, and you can see in addition to add bookmark, I have add bookmark for four tabs. If you want to see two Safari windows at the same time, you could already have done this using split view, but now you get the full toolbars for that. So if I put another Safari window up here, I jump to that, you can see I get the toolbars there at the top of both of those. So you can even do one thing in Safari for iPadOS that you can't easily do on Safari for Mac. That is, take a screenshot that includes the entire web page. So I'm going to take a normal screenshot, but with Safari here as the app on the screen. I'm going to hold the home button and the sleep wake button at the same time. I get the little preview at the bottom left. I'm going to tap that and I go into the mode now where I can mark it up. But at the top of the screen now, I get screen and full page. I can switch to full page and I can now scroll using the little scroll bar at the right side. Scroll up and down and see the entire page here. I can mark it up just as I would before, and I can share it hitting the share button there. So now I can save it as a file, share it any way you normally would. It's just that you get the entire scrolling web page as a screen capture, not just the visible part. So in addition to those specific features, in general, web pages are supposed to behave better, render faster, scroll faster, and just feel a lot more like you're looking at the web page on a MacBook or iMac. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.